Hello peoples, Digital Mouse here. You may be wondering what it's like to use the Legion Go as a desktop PC. I'm going to show you my Legion Go desktop setup, the settings I used, how it performed while gaming with an external monitor, and the productivity software I used. Let's get started. The foundation of my Legion Go desktop is the CalDigit Thunderbolt 4 dock. It has a total of 18 ports to accommodate all my connectivity needs. The front features an SD and micro SD card slot, perfect for transferring videos and photos from my Sony camera for editing. There is an audio jack and a USB-A 3.2 Gen 2 port. Additionally, there are two 3.2 Gen 2 USB-C ports, with one supporting 20 watts of charging. The back of the CalDigit dock has all the ports I need for my accessories. This is what it looks like with everything connected. I use the DisplayPort for my Gigabyte M32U monitor, and one Thunderbolt port connects to my Dell monitor via an HDMI to USB-C cable. The TS4 supports either a single monitor up to 8K resolution, or dual 6K displays at 60Hz using one of the rear Thunderbolt ports. The USB-A ports house the USB for my Logitech SuperLight mouse. The larger USB is for my Scuff controller. The yellow and black braided cable is for my Wooting keyboard. My power adapter is plugged into the bottom left, and one Thunderbolt port connects everything to my Legion Go with one cable. Now, here's the thing. This CalDigit TS4 dock costs $400. And I know what you're about to say. Yo, Mouse, there's no way I'm paying $400 for a dock to connect to my Legion Go. You might want to consider this dock by Ugreen instead. It's the RevoDock Pro 211 Laptop Docking Station. It has SD and micro SD card ports. There are two USB-A ports and a single USB-C port, all of which support 10 gigabytes per second data transfer speeds. There are two HDMI ports, which support dual 4K video at 60Hz, or single 8K video at 30Hz. It's not Thunderbolt 4, but it's also not $400. You're looking at about $65 on Amazon. Whatever dock you choose, you'll definitely want to invest in one of these, a JSOX U-shaped USB-C to USB-C adapter. It'll allow you to attach your dock to your Legion Go and give it a nice clean look, as opposed to having the cable sticking out of the top of it. The Gigabyte M32U is the primary monitor for my Legion Go setup. Its panel size is about 31.5 inches. It supports 10-bit color using 8-bit plus frame rate control, has a max resolution of 3840 by 2160, and a refresh rate of up to 144Hz. It comes with two built-in 3-watt speakers, which are serviceable but not great. The monitor's 1 millisecond response time also helps to reduce ghosting or blurring. Before I start talking about my second monitor, if you like this video, hit the subscribe button. It helps the channel. The second monitor I use with my Legion Go is a Dell that I've had for years. It has a panel size of about 27 inches. It has a max resolution of 1080p with a refresh rate of 60Hz. I keep it in portrait mode. It allows me to preview and transfer files between folders. It's also good for listening to music or watching videos as I'm gaming or video editing. For productivity, I use the Logitech MX Master 3S mouse and MX Keys wireless keyboard. The MX Keys keyboard provides a comfortable typing experience with its quiet and low-profile keys, while the mouse's ergonomics and side scroll make it perfect for video editing. I connect both devices to my Legion Go wirelessly via Bluetooth. To show you the settings for my Legion Go desktop, I want to start in the BIOS and with my choice of VRAM. Hold down the volume up and then press the power button. When you get to this screen, select BIOS Setup. Go into More Settings, Configuration, then UMA Frame Buffer Size. The Legion Go allows you to select Auto for VRAM. In theory, I think this is supposed to adjust your Legion Go's VRAM to whatever size is needed for the particular game you're playing, and for the most part it works. However, after selecting this setting, I tried to play Ratchet & Clank. It started, but suddenly stopped, and I got this error message stating there was not enough VRAM. I also had problems trying to play Cyberpunk. It either wouldn't start or was completely unplayable. I went back and adjusted this setting to 8GB. Changing it to 8GB allowed me to play Ratchet & Clank. And Cyberpunk wasn't great, but it was playable. Let's move on to the desktop. The Legion Go recognized the Gigabyte and Dell monitors, and I didn't have to download drivers for either of them. I went into Device Management and found the Gigabyte and Dell monitors already present. In the display settings, I set the 32-inch Gigabyte monitor as the main display. I set the display resolution to 2560 by 1440. I found this resolution to work for most games. I went into Advanced Display Settings and selected 144Hz refresh rate. One thing I love about using the Legion Go as a desktop is the ability to easily switch between modes and change settings. For example, if I want to switch to gaming mode, I just press the left Legion space button and I have access to my game library and various gaming platforms. Press it again and I go back to Windows desktop. And I also have easy access to the quick settings menu. I just press the quick setting button on the right. While we're here, let me show you my default settings for gaming and video editing. I set the Legion Go to performance mode, thermal mode to performance, fan to smart, and OS power mode to performance. One effect these settings caused in the Legion Go that we definitely need to discuss is the fan noise. It was definitely noticeable as I was using the Legion Go. Now I should also let you know that this Legion Go has a 4TB 2280 SSD installed with the thermal pad. I'll leave a link in the description below to my video on that install. I muted the sound and set up a decibel meter next to my Legion Go to measure the fan noise. I played a game of Call of Duty. During gameplay, the decibel meter measured the fan noise from 46.3 decibels at the low end to 54.4 decibels at the high end. Now, according to the CDC, a ticking watch is 20 decibels, refrigerator hum is 40, an air conditioner is 60, and a washing machine or dishwasher is 70 decibels. So the fan noise of my Legion Go fell between a refrigerator hum and an air conditioner. The fan noise didn't take away from my enjoyment of playing, I just saw there was something that you needed to know. And the noise gave me a great excuse to buy a set of these, Logitech's Pro X2 Lightspeed headsets. I love the build quality of these headsets. Scuff Envision Pro for controller gaming. The ergonomics of the Scuff controller contours seamlessly to my hands. It's so comfortable, it almost feels tailor-made for me. And it's not just the grip. You see these top triggers? The Scuff Envision Pro has enough space in between them that the top of my index fingers naturally fall on them. Now, let's compare that to the ROG Rikiri controller. Here I have to adjust my hands in order to get the top of my index fingers to actuate the top buttons. This is just personal preference, and your mileage is going to vary on this part. But the Scuff Envision Pro has been my go-to controller for desktop gaming with my Legion Go. Now, I want to show you how my Legion Go desktop performed with some of my favorite games. For Call of Duty, I set the resolution to 2560 by 1440. I set the refresh rate to 144Hz. Throughout the game, my frames per second was in the 50s and 60s, sometimes reaching into the 70s. And I didn't detect any lag between the button presses on the Scuff controller and the game itself. It almost felt like playing on a console. For Hades 2, I used the same 2560 by 1440 resolution. During combat, my FPS would get into the 90s and often over 100. For keyboard and mouse gaming, I switched to the Wooting 60HE keyboard and Logitech SuperLight mouse. The SuperLight mouse weighs 59 grams. Its lightweight and ergonomic design makes it easy to maneuver and comfortable to use while gaming. The Wooting 60HE allows for a number of hardware and software customizations. I changed the WASD and spacebar keys to orange keycaps. I like the contrast between the movement keys from the rest of the keyboard. It helps with visibility and allows me to more quickly position my hand. One of the key features of the Wooting 60HE is the ability to change the actuation levels of the keys. You can do that through their software by downloading their app or going online. Wooting will even allow you to save and share presets. I installed this Counter-Strike preset I found online. For my mousepad, I'm using a large size Artisan Ninja. It has a soft top that provides a comfortable surface for me to rest my arm. It's slightly textured but smooth enough to provide a stable glide for my Logitech SuperLight mouse. There's a non-slip rubber base pad on the bottom that consistently stayed in place during gameplay. I used the Wooting 60HE keyboard and Logitech SuperLight mouse while playing Valorant for the last 2 weeks. For Valorant, I kept the resolution at 2560 by 1440 and the refresh rate at 144Hz. I also set several of the other display settings to off or low. As a result, I was able to get my FPS to over 100, often over 120, and sometimes even more than that. My performance with the Wooting 60HE and SuperLight mouse was not great, but I'm terrible at Valorant, so I don't blame the Wooting or SuperLight for that. Honestly, no matter how great the gear, it can't make a bad player good. While playing Fortnite, I maintained the same resolution and refresh rate. During gameplay, my FPS was consistently between 25 and 30. I'm pretty sure I could have gotten that higher if I had lowered some of the graphics settings. Let's talk about productivity software. You won't have any issues running productivity software like Microsoft Word or Google Docs. The Lenovo Legion Go has plenty of power to handle basic tasks. I had an equally easy time using photo editing software like Affinity. It's a powerful program, but the Lenovo Legion Go handled it with ease. Canva is my go-to software for creating YouTube thumbnails. Thanks to the seamless performance of the Lenovo Legion Go, using it was a breeze. I tried video editing on the Legion Go using DaVinci Resolve and CapCut. DaVinci Resolve and CapCut have free and paid versions. They'll both give you free video effects like titles, filters, and transitions. I found the Legion Go struggled more with DaVinci Resolve. Video playback was often slow and stuttered while I was editing 4K video. CapCut was more responsive and provided a better experience. I also found it more intuitive and easy to learn. In fact, this was the first time I ever used CapCut, and I edited this entire video with it. The large screen on the Lenovo Legion Go makes it one of my favorite handheld devices. And after using it as a desktop PC for the last 2 weeks, I can say that if you wanted to use it as your only PC, you absolutely could, as long as your expectations for it aren't too high. It'll work for light gaming and basic productivity tasks. Now, it won't replace the Apple devices that I currently use for productivity, but it has definitely earned a place on my desk. If you like this video, you'll definitely like my other videos coming on the screen right now.